Can you start by telling us a little bit about your character in the production and what excited you about it?
Oh, yeah, I play an egomaniac. Her ego is fueled by her Twitter followers. She has, more Twitter followers than the population of Venezuela or something like that. And she's having a bit of a breakdown. And she's making a comeback. She's a pop star. She's making a comeback in 2015. And, her name is Poppy. And she's great fun to play. She's a nutcase.
And I have to ask, playing a pop star on a comeback, yeah. Is it easy for you to draw on real life experiences? Obviously, S Club 7 on the way back and being a pop star yourself.
Yeah, it's one of the things that really drew me initially to the project because of the parallels and what's going on in my life right now. And yeah, I found that really, really interesting. Hopefully, I'm not as diva-esque as she is, because she's a proper diva. But I like to think that I'm not quite as a head case as she is.
And of course, you're not a diva, but the pop world is full of iconic divas. Were there any in particular that you drew on as kind of inspiration or kind of reference point for a troubled, difficult pop star?
Well, I looked up a few things on YouTube in terms of pulling on famous pop stars to kind of get inspiration from. And yeah, I looked at Britney Spears and also Lady Gaga. Across the board, really. I think sort of everybody out there has had one sort of meltdown, famous meltdown. So there was kind of a lot online to draw upon.
What's it like working in a beautiful and unique space like the Langham Hotel?
It's amazing to be working at the Langham, one of which I love working in the West End in town because it's so convenient. And two, it's just a prestigious, amazing, posh hotel that is just lovely to be working in. And also, we get to use one of the rooms as our dressing room, so that's also quite nice. But above all, our space that we perform in is an absolute treat. It's a really, really intimate space and really, really cosy, and it's got a cabaret feel, and it's dark, and it's kind of got cool, sexy lighting. And yeah, it's a really, really lovely, lovely setting, and it's there, you know, and you don't have to sort of makeshift and and it's there. You don't have to kind of make things up and make a set. It's just all there, and that's really, really nice.
And overall, what do you think an audience is going to take away from this production?
My main thing that I find really interesting about the project is that I hope the audience feel literally like a fly on the wall when they're watching it, and I hope that really, really translates. I'm sure it does, because we are pretty much on top of the audience. It's like a tin of sardines, basically. I don't quite know how our audience manages to get in the rooms following our play, because our room is almost twice as big as the other two. On top of that, I hope that they take away a nice experience. We've got a few different elements in there. We've got music and different time periods. The audience get taken on a journey throughout the hotel, and also from 2015 right back into the past. So it's a really interesting concept, and I'm really happy to be involved. It's exciting.
Later on in the year, we have the very exciting S Club 7 reunion tour. How are you feeling about that?
Very excited about the S Club reunion. My head's not quite on it yet, but I do. In fact, I just realised tonight we start rehearsing in a week. So that'll be fun to go down memory lane and start getting together the repertoire and the music and all that for that. It's going to be great to be back with the guys and getting out there on such a major scale, and the combination of the both is really exciting.
I mean, what do you think fans, after all this time, can expect from the new and improved S Club 7 live show?
Well, hey, I'm not promising that we're new and improved, but they can expect a blast from the past, and it's about celebration, and it's about giving them the music that they listened to when they were growing up. You know, a lot of the fans have said that it's the soundtrack to their childhood, which is lovely to hear. And yeah, it's about getting them tracks out there again and enabling them to come out and remember what it was, what it was like when they were 8 years old, and reminisce and have a night of nostalgia.
Obviously, those songs mean so much to so many different people. For you personally, is there one track in particular you're really looking forward to performing live in front of an audience again?
My favourite track is Don't Stop Moving. It's one of my all-time favourites. Across the board, it's always been my favourite. Also, I heard a cover of it today, which has probably been out for a while, that I'd never heard of before, by The Beautiful South. Tom, who plays my manager, played it just before we went up for a show, and it's actually quite nice. So I might look at maybe doing a different version of Don't Stop Moving. That could be fun. Reach is always a good one. It's always a crowd pleaser. It's quite nice to see everyone's hands go up in the air. So that's always a nice one. Yeah, Reach and Don't Stop Moving.
Have you got a message for fans before you leave us?
Oh, well, if anyone's coming, hope you enjoy it. And, hope we don't look too old. And, we're looking forward to cracking the WD-40 out and getting the Zimmer frames out again.